Good day, my great scholars. You are welcome back to the online class for GS3. And our topic for this week is Taekwondo. Taekwondo for GS3 week 4. You'll be wondering, what is Taekwondo? At the end of the topic today, you should be able to explain what Taekwondo and the basic techniques involves in performing that activity, and should be able to state the importance of Taekwondo, state the rules and regulations governing them. Don't forget, I said there is no game that doesn't have its own regulations. So you should be able to know the state, the rules and regulations for Taekwondo, and at the same time, list the officials involved in Taekwondo. Now, what is Taekwondo? It is a modern martial art which is being derived from the way the hand and the foot is being used. And it is being characterized by the fast and the high and the spinning kicks we have in it. We might be saying Taekwondo, these children that they've not even learned about Taekwondo, they kick, they fight. But all what you know is that Taekwondo is a defensive game. Now, how did we derive the name Taekwondo? Taek, as I'm looking at on the screen, means you kick or you strike with your foot. Yeah. Have you watched Bruce Lee? Bruce Lee, where he fights with his hand and foot. Yes, that is Taekwondo. So Taek means kick and strike with your foot. Y1, the W-O-N means force to strike or block with hand. You want to fight me, but the same, you want to punch me. I did, like this, for me to block with my hand. And the G-O there is the way of art. That was why at the end, we can say Taekwondo is the kicking, the striking, the blocking, and punching. Yes, the kicking, the blocking, and punching. That is what we mean by Taekwondo. Can you see? Can you see this lady with her leg up? Can you see these two children? Can you see them with their hand and their foot? Yes. Can you see that? Now, what is the importance of Taekwondo that we are talking about? One, is a self-defense skill. Yes, when you know how to practice Taekwondo, even if there's anybody that wants to kick your punch, you should be able to defend it. That is number one importance for self-defense. It is not like when you go outside, you want to show everybody that, I know how to do Taekwondo, fight with me, no. No, that is not the reason. But when in case there is a fight along the line, you should be able to defend yourself, whether you are a boy or you are a girl. Another one is achieving physical fitness. When you practice Taekwondo all the time, you'll be fit, you'll be physically fit. You can organize yourself, you coordinate yourself, your muscular strength, your muscular power is there. That keeps you fit. At the same time, it creates fun and entertainment for spectators. When people are there watching those that are doing spectators, they will begin to laugh. Yes, that one can defend himself. Yes, you can see when we watch Bruce Lee film, when he's fighting, you might be saying, he wants to kill him, but at the same time, we are enjoying it. We are enjoying watching the film. We have so many importance. That in your notes, when you copy, you see so many importance of Taekwondo that we are talking about. Now, that is also the skills and techniques. The skills and techniques. The six and techniques is just in 3 points. Can you see? These boys that you're looking at. Can you see the stance? Ready for anybody that is coming. These other ones is kicking. Kick with your legs. And the last one, which is the punch with your hand, or you defend with your hand. Those are the three skills we have under Taekwondo, because it is the art of using your hand and your foot. The hand and your foot is being used in the process. You can see the hand and the legs, the foot being used. Those are the skills. Like I told you, there is no game that doesn't have its own rules and regulation or skills and techniques involved. So these are the techniques, the skills and techniques involved in Taekwondo. That takes us to the rules and regulation. The person that performs Taekwondo is Taekwondoist. Is Taekwondoist. Every Taekwondoist must wear a clean and ironed Taekwondo outfit. You don't just pick your clothes from somewhere. I want to go for Taekwondo. The clothes are so rough. No. You must wear a clean and ironed Taekwondo outfit. Another one is the contestant must not eat, chew, smoke, or eat in the field. Some of us, when you're in the field watching, you can chew, you can do so many things. But the Taekwondoist contestant must not eat, chew gum, smoke, or eat in the field. It is a rule, and it must be followed. Another one is every contestant must be at the venue on time. It was not come late. Some of us, whenever I want to do in town sports, 100 meter junior boys will be like, where is Shola? Where is Kolade? Where is Shupo? Where is Fumilola? It shouldn't be. Under Taekwondo, as a contestant, you must arrive at the venue on time. Shouldn't come late. Should arrive there in time. The officials that are involved in Taekwondo. Don't forget, I'll still continue to use football as an example. Football, you have the referee, you have the linesman, you have the flagman, you have the recorder. So the officials you have to under Taekwondo. You have the juries, the referees, the judges, the umpire, the recorder, and the timekeeper. The juries make sure the uniform of the contestant are in order, and the referee is the one to coordinate the game or the competition. The judges are those ones that are judging. Yes, this one is having this one. Yes, this is how it should be. The umpire is the one that is directing the affairs of that particular place where they are using for the competition, and the recorder is there to record the point for each other, and the timekeeper is to keep to the time, when to start and when it is time for them to stop the game. Those are the officials for Taekwondo: the juries, referees, the judges, the umpire, the recorder, and the timekeeper. You can see so many colors: white, yellow, orange, green, purple, blue, brown, red, and black. These are the color of belts they put on in Taekwondo. Some ages put on different colors. Some rank put on different colors. Let me take you back to this lady. You can see that the lady is putting on black belt. While these ones are putting on blue belts, and the other one, red belts. Yes, that is how it is. You can see this one too. Blue belt, yellow belt, and red belt. Different stages with different belts. Different competitions with different belts. And when you are one, you have different belts you put on. That was why I seen those color of belts. Those are different colors of belts they put on in Taekwondo. Let me take you back again. Don't forget, I said Taekwondo is a defensive game where foot and hand is being used. You use it to defend yourself. when you use it to defend yourself, there is no crime in that. It's only that you don't just go out there and be fighting anyhow. If you do that, they will withdraw your rank, your belt from you. It shouldn't be. It's only when being attacked, then you can tell them that, yes, you can defend yourself. That is what I can do. It's good. In this so-called Nigerian, even as a girl, you should be able to defend yourself. So it is good for you to go for the training of taekwondo. If you have been privileged or opportune, please go for it, especially the girls. This so-called nowadays that all the so-called raping are online, you should be able to defend yourself. So it is good for you to go for the training of taekwondo. I believe with this union, that's what taekwondo is, the rules and regulations, and the importance of it in human's life. When you go to the school website, copy your notes and read. See you during next class. Thank you. And God bless.